Welcome to this brief guide on how to embed fonts in PowerPoint. Have you ever meticulously crafted a PowerPoint presentation only to have it look completely different when opened on another computer? It's frustrating, right? Well, I'm here to tell you that those days are over. Embedding fonts in PowerPoint is the key to ensuring your presentations look exactly as you intended, no matter where they're viewed. Imagine this, you've poured your heart into a presentation using a unique font that perfectly captures your brand or message. But when you share it with someone else, the recipient opens it up and disaster. The font is missing and it's been replaced with a generic substitute, and your beautiful slides are now a jumbled mess. This is where font embedding comes to the rescue. Let's walk through how to do it. With your PowerPoint presentation open, click on the File tab in the top left corner. The Backstage menu will appear. Find and click on Options. You'll see a new window pop up. On the left-hand side of this window, select the Save tab. Now, look for a section titled Preserve Fidelity when sharing this presentation. Here's the magic checkbox, Embed fonts in the file. Go ahead and check that box. You'll notice that there's two options below it. Embed only characters used in the presentation. This is a great choice if you're concerned about file size. PowerPoint will only embed the specific characters that are found in your slides. And then there's Embed all characters. This option embeds the entire font, even characters that you haven't used. This is handy if someone else needs to edit your presentation later on. Choose the option that best suits your needs and then click on OK at the bottom of the window. Now, when you save your presentation, those fonts will be packed right in, ensuring your slides look perfect on any device. But before we can embed fonts, we need to find them and install them on our computer. There's a whole world of fonts out there just waiting to be discovered. Some popular free resources include Google Fonts, which has a vast library of free, high-quality fonts. Font Squirrel, which is a curated collection of free fonts with a focus on commercial use. And DaFont, which has a wide variety of free fonts, including some quirky and unique options. Once you've found a font that you love, be sure to download it. It will usually come in a zip file. Extract the files and then right-click on the font file. It'll likely have either a TTF or OTF extension, and choose Install. Now, your new font is ready to use in PowerPoint. Do you want to have several different fonts in your presentation? Well, no problem. PowerPoint will let you embed as many fonts as you need. But remember, the more fonts you embed, the larger your presentation file will become. But if maintaining the visual integrity of your design is top priority, then embedding all characters for each font is the way to go. Even with embedded fonts, you might still encounter a few hiccups though. Perhaps a font isn't displaying quite right. In that case, you can try re-embedding it. Sometimes a simple refresh will do the trick. If the problem persists, it's possible that the font itself might not be embeddable. Some fonts have licensing restrictions that can prevent embedding. Luckily, you can check the font's permissions to see if this is the case. Here's how to do that. Find the font file that you're trying to use. It's typically found in the Fonts folder in your Windows Control Panel or in the New Fonts section in the Settings application. Right-click on the font file and click on Properties. A window will open displaying information about the font. What you want to look for is embedding permissions. This information is usually under the Details tab. You'll typically see one of the following: Installable, which means that this font can be installed and used on your computer. Editable, which means that the font can be embedded in documents for editing. Preview and print, which means the font can be embedded, but only for viewing and printing purposes. Recipients won't be able to edit the text using that font. And then restricted. This font cannot be embedded at all. If you see preview and print or restricted, This means that the font's creator has not allowed it to be fully embedded for editing purposes. In these cases, you may want to find a similar font that has the necessary permissions. But don't despair. There are often very similar fonts available that you could use instead. This is a great opportunity to explore new fonts and find alternatives that still fit your design vision. Now, you're equipped with even more tools to make your PowerPoint presentations look their absolute best. Remember, embedding fonts is the key to ensuring your PowerPoint presentations always look their best. So go ahead and try out different fonts and styles. Now you have the power to control exactly how your presentations are viewed, no matter which device they're on. Be sure to give it a go today, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.